हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, गुड मॉर्निंग। दिस इज हरेंद्र तिवारी, योर केमिस्ट्री एजुकेटर फ्रॉम एलपीएम पब्लिक स्कूल गोलाबाजार गोरखपुर। इन दिस वीडियो आई एम गोइंग टू इंट्रोड्यूस यू अनदर न्यू टॉपिक। दिस इज द आइसोटोप फ्रॉम द चैप्टर ऑफ द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ एटम, क्लास 9th स्टैंडर्ड केमिस्ट्री। What is the meaning of isotope? How this terms came in existence? This terms is related to what? We will get the answer of all these questions. First of all, I tell you, give you the one question. Suppose there is a two atoms. The some information given about two atoms, atom X and Y atom. The number of proton in X is 20 and number of protons in X is 20. Number of neutron in X 21, number of neutron in Y 22. Mass number of X, so as we know, mass number is the sum of the number of protons and number of neutrons. So mass number of X will be 41 and mass number of Y will be 42. As we know that number of proton is the characteristics of a particular atoms that is belong to a particular element. If a group of the atoms has the same number of protons, means that group of atoms belongs from the same elements. Means that group of atoms are the same elements. Is it clear? So here this group of these two atoms X and Y both has the same number of protons. So what we can observe from here, what we can conclude from here, we can conclude from here X and Y are same element. So both atoms we can write here same element. Same elements. Why both atoms are the same elements or belong from the same elements? Because both atoms are having the same number of proton. Is it clear? Both atoms are different with respect to the number of neutron and with reference to the mass number. Do you know what we call such type of relation? This relation is known as isotope. This relation is known as isotope. If we have such a different atoms which has different number of protons but different number of neutrons, and because of that their mass number is differ, so that group of the atoms is known as isotopes. So we can write the definition of isotope here. Iso means same and tope means place. Since proton is characterized the number of atomic number and atomic number is the responsible to decide the position of each and every elements in the periodic table. So the in periodic table the position of the element is decided by their atomic number, and atomic number is depend on the number of protons. That's why we given the terms is the isotopes, because a group of the atoms which has a group of atoms has same number of proton but different number of neutron we call isotopes. In another way, we can say that a group of atom has same atomic number and different mass number, we call that group of atoms isotopes. Means that group of atoms has the relationship among them, that is isotopes, that is pronounced, that is named a terms isotope. Is it clear? So isotopes, basically the atoms which has same number of protons and different number of neutrons, which leads to change in the atomic numbers, same number of protons, so atomic number remains same, but different number of protons, that leads to make the mass number different. So this is the, we can define in that two different way, means the main cause of this definition, the first definition whatever I have wrote here, this is the main cause, this is indirect definition. Clear? So if I ask you in what manner the isotopes are different to each other, so they different to each other with respect to the fundamental particles of the atom, that fundamental particles is the neutron. We will understand it the better way by taking the example of hydrogen. Here the example of isotope going to write here hydrogen. One, this is mass one, this is mass two and mass three. After the analysis of the hydrogen elements, we got the different three types of the atoms present in a given sample. Most means that 99% around this atoms of hydrogen contribute in the hydrogen elements, this is the having mass 1 and atomic number 1, means we call it is the protium, this is called the deuterium and this is called the tritium. A given sample of the hydrogen elements is having the three different types of the atoms, and all these three different types of the atoms are different with each other with respect to the mass, their mass number. A atom of the hydrogen which contributed the most, this is the protium, then less than the, means in a 1%, 99% contribution of the protium, and in 1% there is the contribution of these two elements. Another point about it, if I write here, so protium has one proton in the nucleus and one electron in the cell. Deuterium has one proton and one neutron in the nucleus and one electron in the cell. Tritium has one proton and two neutron in the nucleus and one electron. Means electrons are same, protons are same, but neutrons are different. So isotopes are different with each other with respect to the fundamental particles of atom is neutron. This is clear? So this is the one example. Another example is that carbon, atomic number 6, mass number 12, carbon 12, carbon 13 and carbon 14. So number of proton, if we find out the number of protons, so here the 6, number of protons 6, number of protons 6. Number of neutron, so number of neutrons 6 plus 6, 12, 6 plus 7, 13 and 6 plus 8, 14. Means the isotopes of the carbon different with reference to the number of neutrons. Neutron. Clear? This is the isotopes, the hydrogen tritium and carbon C14. This is known as the radioactive isotopes. So radio, if a question is that which isotopes is commonly known as radioactive isotopes of the carbon, to carbon 14. Which isotopes of the hydrogen is radioactive isotopes, radioactive isotope? So tritium is the radioactive isotopes. Is it clear? Now we have concluded that isotopes are different with each other with the number of neutrons. Is it clear? So a group of atoms which has the same number of neutrons, protons, but different number of neutrons, or in another word, we can say that a group of atoms which has same atomic number but different mass number, we call them isotope. Clear? Now, general characteristics of isotopes. General characteristic properties of isotope. So first of all, isotopes have same atomic number. They have same atomic number. Same atomic number. Clear? Means, for example, hydrogen, protium, deuterium, and tritium, both are having the same atomic number. Clear? Number two, they have different mass number. Number. Clear? Number three, we can write chemical properties are same. Chemical properties are same. All isotopes have the same chemical properties. Means, why they have the same chemical properties? Because their chemical properties is based depend on the number of protons. Since number of protons is determine the number of electrons, and during chemical combination the number of electrons takes part. That's why every isotope has the same number of electrons and protons, because of that their chemical properties are same. Clear? Number four is that, what about the physical property? So physical properties are different. Physical property are different. Why physical property are they different? Because their mass number different. Physical properties such as, physical properties such as melting point, boiling point, density, etc. Because their mass numbers are different, and mass number play a great role to increase or decrease of melting points, boiling point, or density. If the molecular mass increases, their melting points or boiling points increases. If the molecular mass increases, density also increases. As we know that density is equal to mass upon volume, means density is directly proportional to the mass. This point clear? Another is that their nuclear properties is different. Nuclear properties are different. So what is the meaning of nuclear properties here? The meaning of nuclear properties is that, let the example of carbon, just I told you, carbon 12, carbon 13 and carbon 14. So carbon 14, it is different than carbon 12 and carbon 13 because it is the radioactive. When we compare the hydrogen, protium, deuterium and tritium, for hydrogen deuterium we can write the symbol D, and for tritium we use the T. For protium it remains. So when you compare these three, so this is the form, the combined with the water form the H2O, that we call the D2O, right? So this is the known as heavy water, and it is used in the nuclear reactor. One point, nuclear properties are different because of that. This is the radioactive. This is the radioactive, means it is not stable such as protium. Radioactive isotopes. So in such, these are the general characteristics property of isotopes. Is it clear? You have noted down, then I will discuss with you the importance and use of these isotopes. Application of isotopes. What are the applications? The first, in agriculture. There are different elements such as boron, cobalt, manganese, zinc, molybdenum. This is the essential nutrient for the plant. We use the different isotopes atoms to identify the presence of these elements in the plant. If there are lackness of these elements, we give the supplement to the plants. So this is the one application. The next is in industry. In industry, have you observed ever, there is that watch. So in watch, that is watch is the warm of watch is sparking, means they are glowing in dark because we use a radium, which is a radioactive isotopes of the radium, that is absorbing the light in daytimes and in the night times, that is glow, that radiate the radiation. Because of that radiations, arm is glowing. Next is that in medicine, for example, cobalt 60, we use in the treatment of cancer. In treatment of cancer, cobalt 60 is the isotope of cobalt 60, mass number. Iodine 131, it is used in the treatment of goiter. In lack of the iodine 131, the thyroxine hormones not synthesized in our thyroxine gland, and because of that our thyroid glands become it's like a ball. Might you have observed in the some persons that is there this here the thyroid gland, so this gland is become swollen. That disease is called the goiter. So we use the iodine 131. This is the isotopes of iodine in the treatment of goiter. Next is the in carbon dating. It is a phenomenon to estimate the age of fossil fuels. So we can estimate the age of fossil fuels or fossils, not only fuels, fossils. The isotopes of carbon we use to estimate the age of fossils. Clear? Next is in nuclear reactor. Uranium 235 we use in the nuclear reactor. This is the great source of the energy. Is it clear? So these are the application of isotopes. That's all. Now here the some problem we have to do. Problem 1, identify the isotope in given atoms. So here X atomic number 15, mass number 25, Y 14, mass number 30, Z 15, mass number 27, K 14, mass number 28, A 20, mass number 40, B 14, mass number 29, C 40, mass number 19, D 20, mass number 42. So these are the different groups of the atoms given. So we have to classify them in the isotopes. So what are the isotopes? 15, atomic number. We have to find out the atomic number. So atomic number 15 means X and Z. Sorry, both I have written the Z. X and Z are isotope of each other. Clear? Next, Y 14, K 14, and B 14. So Y K, Y, K and B are isotope. Clear? Another, D and A. A and D are isotopes. Clear? C, no have the relation. So in the given groups, we have classified into three groups. X and Z are isotopes, Y, K, B are isotopes, A and D are isotopes. Is it clear? Now we have to do another problem. It was very simple. This is the last problem, problem number two. Classify the given atoms in the group of isotope. Atom given, suppose X 25. Y, X, information given here, the atom, this is the atom and the number of neutrons and mass number given, mass number. So atom X, Y, K, B, D, M, these are number of neutron. 20, 14, 18, 16, 17, 13. Mass number, suppose 40, 28, 32, 33, 30, 26, this mass number given. So we have to find out the group of isotopes. Clear? So for that we should have the information about the number of protons. So number of protons we need to estimate. 40 minus 20, 20. As we know that mass number is equal to number of proton plus number of neutron. So 14, 28, 14, 18 and 32. So what value will come? 12 minus 8, 4, and 3 minus 2 minus 1, 1. Clear? 16 minus 33, so that will be 17, and 17 minus 30, so it will be 13, and 13 minus 27, 13. Clear? You add 20 plus 20, 40, 14 plus 14, 28, 18 plus 14, 32, or 16 plus 17, 33, 17 plus 13, 30, and 13 plus 13, 26. So now we got that the same number of protons, the group. So Y and K, D and M. So here two group of the isotopes are present. The first is that Y and K, and second D and M or isotopes. So this is the answer. So the assignment question I will give you in the PDF note. So at last I tell you, thank you. Wish you all the best. Do study.